I've always been talking to animals. मुझे बचपन से ये जानना था कि वो क्या सोच रहे हैं. I thought they had nothing to say back to me.
ये है राजू. This is a silkworm.
But as it turns out, they do. We're somewhere on the outskirts of Pune right now, and we're going to Japaloop farm. I'm going to meet Manjiri Late. She can talk to animals telepathically.
तो टेलीपैथी में ये एनिमल्स हमारे साथ हमारे ये इंटरनल सेंसेस से हम रिसीव करते हैं इंफॉर्मेशन एंड इट्स स्टिल अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल टू वे कॉन्वर्सेशन.
पर्सनली आई फाइंड इट काइंड ऑफ अब्सर्ड. आई मीन आई डोंट वांट टू लाइक शिट ऑन इट और एनीथिंग बट एज फार एज लाइक गेटिंग वाइब्स फ्रॉम नेचर एंड एनिमल्स I'm not really sure how it works.
It's the easiest thing one can do. Okay. We all do it from birth, actually.
Okay.
When you're genuinely thinking of somebody, their phone call comes in, mm-hmm. or an SMS comes in, and you tell the person, "Oh, I was just thinking about you," oh, and your message came in. So, ye telepathy
is that telepathy?
It is. Okay. Ye hamare life mein.
It was like coincidence.
Nah. In the universe, they say there are no coincidences.
तेरी रीढ़ की हड्डी में दर्द नहीं होता? मेरे तो बहुत होता है. आर यू नेचुरल ब्लॉन्ड?
व्हाट डिड यू से देन?
सो व्हेन यू से लाइक दे स्पीक टू यू, व्हाट डज इट लाइक साउंड लाइक और लाइक
सो एनीबॉडी इफ वी आर जस्ट सिटिंग बाय आवरसेल्व्स वी हैव इमेजिनेशंस इन आवर हेड ऑफ अ कन्वर्सेशंस वी ईदर हैड विद समबडी इन द पास्ट अ फैमिली मेंबर और अ फ्रेंड और अ कन्वर्सेशन दैट वी आर स्लेटेड टू हैव. So we already have an internal representation mm-hmm. of a person mm-hmm. with a visual and an internal sound. Same five senses, they use the same pathways to, or rather we receive through the same pathways. Mini, are you happy with Hampton being around you? Do you think it's going to be a boy? Togo, are you happy with your life at the farm? Are you happy with it? What is the next date you reckon that you're going to become mama? Would you like any help?
But like how do you teach something like this or learn it?
Bilkul.
I mean if you could like show
absolutely.
Me as well, I mean.
In all honesty there is no teaching that needs to be done. It is actually unlearning.
Achha.
An unlearning of the logical frame of mind that we are all trained to. And get back in touch with our natural instincts or our natural abilities. So we'll first go with just yes and no based responses.
Okay.
And just go with the first response you get in your gut.
Okay.
Okay. And these yeses and nos are something that we get for something as simple as a friend calls up and says, are you coming for a movie? And andar se hi aapko pata hai, jana hai ya nahi hai. Not rocket science, very easy. And just we'll ask Mini one more time that, Mini, would you like us to help you in any way?
Yes, first, I think.
Beautiful, yeah. Beautiful, absolutely. So it's
I
a very
a breeze, so
nice,
maybe
great.
That counts.
That's your own yardstick to go by.
Brilliant. I honestly tried. I did. She asked the question and then I waited for some answer from the universe or my gut feeling, but I got nothing.
So what we were trying to do back there, where mm-hmm. you asked the question and you asked me to.
Right.
Say what I was feeling
right,
at that moment,
right?
Right. And so I want to ask you, like, say if I'm feeling something, but how do you know if it's right? I could be feeling something where it could just
sure.
be anything random.
Sure.
How
nice.
Do you do that?
Okay. So in the earlier stages, a lot of people go through this
mm-hmm.
because the confidence building needs to happen.
Right.
That is it my imagination or is it the animal talking to me?
Right.
So starting ke phases, what helps is having somebody to help validate for you. It seems as if they are not put together very often until this happened.
No, they never hung out together. They're different, separate bands.
Yeah.
But it's amazing because they've just kind of...
They're getting along
yeah.
with, yeah. There's a young girl he speaks about.
Crush on someone.
Nah. Very young girl.
One of my picnickers who comes regularly.
Who
and
seems to have great affection
for
him.
Yeah.
Little girl
little
in a
girl.
Dress.
Okay.
I mean, I was really surprised to see how Manjari was really kind of helping Lorraine and Rohan, and because they were relating with a lot of the things she was saying. I don't know how it happens though, but. What is the image? I want to understand what the image is.
Generally, they know their body clock beautifully well. Mm-hmm. So if you're asking her a question saying, do you know by when do you think you're going to deliver? Usually a numeric will just come up, like an internal image in your head, a numeric comes up, and it's a matter of us just trusting and verbalizing it. So isme hum galat ya barabar nahi hai, we are just telling them what the animal is sharing with us. Our aim is only to become a voice for that animal. It's again not anything that we are planting from our end or interpreting from our end. For example, a cell phone doesn't decide are there two angels talking to each other or two really nasty people talking to each other. What does a cell phone do? Just carry waves from one end to the other.
I get where she's coming from, but honestly, there just wasn't enough tangible proof. Because to me, most of Manjari's assessment could be classified as good observation rather than a product of telepathy. I guess a vet would have given similar feedback for the horses. However, some of the things that Manjari spoke about were creepily specific, like that little girl who visits Togo the ox. I was in desperate need to find out more about this interspecies sorcery. Luckily, just before I decided to call it a day, Manjari told me about Akshaya Kaule in Mumbai, who finds lost pets.
Kahan ja rahe?
What are you doing?
Huh?
Yes.
So what exactly is so special about this place?
So this is one of the places where one of the missing dogs was found, because I communicated with him and I asked him, where are you, how are you feeling, and he described this location, a small place, paved blocks, okay, dimly lit.
Right.
And all these elements put together, I interpreted them and I told the parent. And she could find him here.
So you've actually never been here?
No, this is my first time being here. This is the first time I am seeing the place as well.
You've only seen it in your...
Yes, yes. I've only seen what the dog showed me.
So you were also telling me about one case with where they lost both the pets, right?
Yes, so this is the same case that I was talking about. So where the human lost both her animals.
Okay.
They went missing, a cat and a dog, in a span of a month.
Both of them?
Yes, both of them.
Okay.
And we communicated with them and they are both home safe now with her.
Okay.
So let's go to her house and we can talk to her about her experience with animal community.
Yeah, sure. Why not? I can't really say that this is entirely scientific or like it's not proven scientifically. So how
do you... If you ask me, it is entirely non-scientific.
Right.
Because science needs proof.
Right.
And this has no proof. It
exactly.
is just a feeling.
Yeah.
So, now there are so many radiation waves which we cannot see, but they exist.
Hmm.
So, similarly, like this telepathic connection is something which we can't visualize. There is no proof, but it is there.
So, one was a dog. He got lost. What about the cat?
So, I think he was out for 15 days or so.
Yeah, and I was not very sure. She told me that he says that he wants to explore the world outside.
He went on a backpacking
trip. So, 50, yeah, so it was like one of those movies, you know, when they want to go, coming of age and they want to go out. It was that.
Can you, I know this is hard, but can you take me through like the process of how you start talking with them?
Usually I begin with setting the intention. So kiske saath baat karni hai. For example, if I wish to speak to Manchi, who's a cat belonging to Bharti aunty. So a commonly asked question is usually kitni sari Bharti aunty honge aur kitne sare Manchis honge. So how do you know cross connection nahi ho raha hai? So that is because you have set the intention that you want to speak to this Bharti aunty's Manchi. And Manchi also knows that is the Manchi I wish to speak to. So koi aur Manchi aake wo conversation ko intercept nahi karne wala hai. It's like an encrypted WhatsApp chat.
That's a great way to put it. Talking to animals telepathically is like an encrypted WhatsApp chat. But could it really be that easy? I mean, even Google Maps is not that accurate. Meanwhile, Bharti aunty decided to take a trip down memory lane.
My main dog is Goofy. Because time I have given him, I have not given any other dog. So when she taught me how to communicate, I communicated with him. And I told him, I miss you very much. So he told me, Mama, why are you missing me? I'm with you. I was Snoopy, I'm Goofy. I was Benji and now I'm Bingo.
As I sat there judging Bharti aunty, I couldn't help but wonder, was getting some first-hand experience the only way to get to the bottom of this? Maybe if I could talk to my dog, Samson, I could get some clarity. P.S. Samson has been dead for like 10 years.
Right?
Yes.
That's all you need?
Yes, that's okay. All I
have. Right.
Okay.
This is freaky.
So, hi Samson, how are you?
Hi Sam.
Samson to me comes across as a very energetic dog. He was very playful, he loved the outdoors, and he was very close to your brother and you.
Yeah.
With you, he was more like partners in crime.
Yeah.
So you used to do a lot of masti with him, like physically bother him a lot.
Yeah.
He shows me a mother-like figure, so like I'm assuming it's your mom. She used to talk to him and she used to treat him like one of the boys. With your father, he shared a very respectable relationship. So, jitna bhi masti rehta tha, it used to be away from your dad. Both of them looked at each other as, you know, anchors. Like, Samson also showed an older woman in the house. So, did you have your grandmother or anybody else apart from your mother who was around?
Yeah, my daddy used to be around. Yeah. Yes, she still is. Okay.
Yeah. You can ask more questions. This is what he has to share.
So I hadn't seen Sam when he passed away for about 2 years when he passed away and I wasn't there. No one was there actually. So I don't know, maybe did he feel bad that no one was around when he died?
So no, he didn't feel bad. He was in fact quite relieved that he could go on his own without anybody actually having to see him go like that.
Right.
So he had a very happy life.
Hmm.
He wants you and he wants you to tell your family that he did enjoy his time with you guys.
Huh. Mm. It's interesting because, he spent a lot of time with my father alone because my dad was living in the field area in Jammu.
Okay.
I mean, yes, you are right in the fact that I used to like say, usko bahut tang karta tha, main uske se poonch ooch khinchta tha, and he used to bite me and all. It's so specific and so vague at the same time. I'm not really sure what to make of it. I'm really confused because I say one part of my brain says that this is all like bullshit.
That's okay. That's
and
completely
the other part,
okay.
Now that you tell me some things, yeah, I mean, they sound true.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, how's it going, man?
Are you still rolling?
I
think I came out of that conversation more confused than when I went into it. The thought of conversing with my dead dog Sam was eerie. And to me, most of what Akshaya told me was very general and vague. Except for the part about the kind of relationship Sam shared with my father. How she was able to come up with that, I'm still not sure. Maybe she can really talk to dead pets. Or maybe she was just lucky. I think at the end of the day, it's all a matter of faith. And personally, I think it's great that communicators like Manjari and Akshaya, through telepathy, are able to help people find their lost pets or get closure, no matter how absurd the practice may seem. Maybe if I was not such a cynic, this could have been a cathartic experience for me.
Do you believe in God? I think that was a yes.